obstinate. இன்வொகேஷன்லாம் சொல்லணுமா? வேண்டாம்ல. ஓகே, ஐ டோன்ட் திங்க் யூ ஹேவ் டு சே இன்வொகேஷன். The question is in relation to the qualities of the mind, obstinate, dridham. What does one do? When the mind is obstinate, you have to use force. There is no other. When the mind is obstinate, it will not be yielding to reason. Obstinate itself means what? Unyielding. And to the unyielding mind, you don't try logic and reason. You have to use force in the sense, that's what in the next verse he says, abhyasa, practice. The solution he has given in the next verse. What does one do? Practice is a force. Any practice involves effort, and all efforts are forces which the mind will not like. Mind will say, spoon feed me, and it will stay quiet. It will not want to do anything. Are you able to follow? It will be very comfortable if the other digest the nutrients and directly inject the nutrients instead of me eating. Instead of me eating, swallowing, digesting, distributing, I have so many other important things to do in life. Who has time for these things? So what do you do? Anyway, you don't have anything to do. What do you do? Simply digest the food and give me the nutrients. It doesn't work that way. So for all this nature, you have to practice. Practice means, the word practice involves effort. The word practice involves effort. The word practice involves the mind resisting. Both are involved in that. Whenever we talk about practice, two things are involved. One is the effort. Why it is an effort? Because of the mind resisting it. Effort itself is because of the mind's resistance. That's why he said, are you able to follow? That's why he beautifully said in the verse 35, where he said beautifully in verse number 35, practice Arjuna. You got to practice. And practice involves effort. Effort means the mind is resisting. Effort means the mind is resisting. Mind resist. What does the mind resist? It's a universal problem. That's why he says, Asamshayam Mahabaho, don't worry. You are not the only person to suffer like this. Everybody has this problem. And when you know everybody has this problem, there is a relief. Only if you have, only you are the problem, then that's it. Still remember long back, where we used to have those power failures. One of my aunt will say, "Pakkathu veetla poittha paaru," she will say. See whether the power is gone in the next house also. And if you see, you come out onto the street and you see power is gone in all the houses, there is a satisfaction. What is the satisfaction? That you are not the only one who is suffering. There is a whole lot that is along with you suffering. So the group suffering is a satisfaction. Asamshayam Mahabaho, he says. Beautiful verse. Asamshayam, without doubt. He agreed, without doubt. How to make the mind to practice? A combination of effort and the knowledge. Vairagya means knowledge. Vyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. Two practices. That how you can deal with the formula that it's not only to that one. The formula that is given in 35 is applicable to all facets. Practice means a force, an effort. Vairagya implies knowledge. So by the combination of knowledge and effort, asamshayam, without doubt, it can be controlled. For how do we say vairagyam is knowledge? Vairagyam comes through knowledge, isn't it? Through the study and reflection you get. How do you get vairagya? Vairagya comes through knowledge. So what is the solution that is giving? Effort and knowledge. Effort and knowledge. For knowledge by itself cannot change. Effort without knowledge also is useless. So it has to be combined. Effort and knowledge. A person has read all the books on swimming. He has done a doctoral research on swimming and not gotten into water at all. It is possible, no? Correct? It is possible, isn't it? He can have a doctoral thesis on swimming and yet he would not have even touched water. And he'll be still thinking whether to get into water or not. So as you are testing waters, what the coach will do from the back? What the coach will do from you? He'll just push you into the water. And you are drowning as it were. Yeah. Drink and you think that's the end of your life. He's pushing you because he is there to save you. That's why he's pushing you. Isn't it? That we don't have. That the mind cannot understand. He's pushing you. Why? Because you know, when you do something like that, he will jump and he will, that effort the mind will not. So how do you do that? You got to put into practice. And practice, as far as the mind is concerned, is very difficult. So what do they do to make the mind practice? They say, develop an affinity to it. The moment the mind develops an affinity to it, practice becomes relatively easy. You have to develop a affinity. That's why nowadays they say you should be passionate about it. You should love what you are doing. How can the mind love what it is doing when the mind itself is so confused from morning till evening? Understand it. Mind is a million of thoughts, no thinking. That is mind. Just thoughts. Millions of thoughts is the mind without thinking. It doesn't think, it just flows. And that flowing itself is not, and that flowing is not thinking. That just the mind flowing is not thinking. Mind is just millions of thoughts. No thinking. So what it will do, it will go in one direction. It will be attracted to it for a while and then leaves and goes to something else. This is the nature of the mind. Second thing about the mind. Keep making a note, Vijay. Naa marandruvan pramo. Don't ask me to repeat alla. Rewind pannunga, I will not know how to rewind. Video na rewind pannunga pramo. First is, mind is a million of thoughts. No thinking. Second thing about the mind. Double standards is the mind. It will have one standard for itself. It will want the other to understand itself, but it will not make an effort to understand the other. That's double standards. Mind is that. Mind is a million of thoughts. If you understand all this about the mind, you know how dangerous is this thing that you are living with. This is the knowledge, and this knowledge brings about vairagya. Are you able to follow? First thing, mind is a million of thoughts. Second is, it has double standards. What is a double standard? It says, to put it very simply, see, you expect me to be conscious of what I am talking, isn't it? Correct, huh? But I can't expect you to be conscious and listen to what I am talking, no? Are you able to follow? In that double standard. This is what is called as, are you able to follow the example? See, you expect me to be conscious, and if I expect you to be conscious in return, you will say, no, don't expect me to do that. But I will expect you to do that. This is the mind. Third, mind loves to be a slave by constantly complaining about the world. Mind loves to be a slave. That's why, see, all these are universal problems. Huh? What we are discussing is not unique to Arjuna. It is a universal problem. That's why Krishna straightway agreed with Arjuna, because it is a universal problem, and the entire message of Shastras is to address this universal problem. The entire message of Vedanta is to address this universal problem. What is the third thing about the mind I said just now? It loves to remain a slave by constantly complaining. It loves to remain a slave. Why? Because it says complaining is the way of not wanting to take responsibility. Complaining is the way by which the mind doesn't want to take responsibility. Responsibility to what? It says, I am not the cause for my worry and anxiety. The person sitting next to me is the cause. It says, the person sitting next to me is the cause. I am not the... That's how the mind loves to remain a slave. It tells you as though it wants freedom, but it loves to remain a slave. It tells you, I want to be free. And when the methodology to achieve freedom is told, the mind says, I want freedom. When the methodology to get that freedom, when Vedanta gives the methodology to give, to get that freedom, what does the mind say? What you are saying doesn't work. Why? Because you are attacking the wrong person. All that you are saying is correct, sir, but teach this to the next person, not to me. Because I am perfect already. You soldier is correct. But only the person is, you are talking to the wrong person, that's all. Are you able to follow? This is what the mind is made up of. So it constantly wants to complain. In that complaining, it has a justification. What is the justification? I am helpless. I am a victim. And are you able to follow?
Slave of the world.
Because mind loves to remain a slave of the world. Slave of what? Very good. To the world. Last, mind always wants to be in conflict. Mind likes to be in fight. That's why colloquially also we say, sir, at least veetla sanda poradhukaga oru aal varum, this, isn't it? You need at least somebody to to fight with. Silence is like graveyard, sir. It is like a graveyard. You know, mind loves to be in. Mind is that which loves conflict. Are you able to follow? Conflict means fighting, proving, establishing something. That is conflict. All this understanding brings about a vairagya. All this understanding of the mind brings about a vairagya. What is the vairagya? What is the vairagya? The trouble is within me only. I cause my own. Nobody causes trouble to me except myself. It loves to. Mind is that which can survive only in conflict. Mind cannot survive in peace. Mind survives only in conflict. Either within yourself or with the other person or with the world. But somehow there has to be a why. Because in a conflict alone, you can. Conflict means you have to. Something is happening in you. Are you able to follow? Something is pushing. You can win and you can feel superior. You can lose and you can feel inferior. Are you able to follow? If you win, it will feel superior. If it loses, it feels inferior. But it can never be in reality. Are you able to follow? It can never be in reality. Arjuna's question is, how can we control this mind? Are you able to follow? How can we control this mind? By practice and vairagya. What is practice? Till now I said, what is vairagya? Are you okay? Huh? Are you okay till now? What is practice? Practice is developing an affinity with, you can practice, and the practice will be less with minimum strain, least strain, if you develop an affinity. Affinity means you understand the importance, you understand the value, you understand the greatness. When will affinity come? Only when you see one way in which the mind develops its own affinity, which is self-destructive. What is the way in which the mind develops its own affinity, which is self-destructive? 62-63. Verse number 62-63, chapter 2. Dhyayato vishayan pumsaha sangaste shupajayate sangahat sanjayate kamaha. All that. Just by continuously, repeatedly, the thoughts go towards one person or one object, it develops a kind of attachment. That is not affinity. Here what we mean is an affinity you develop through discrimination. An affinity you develop through proper knowledge and understanding. Not just the mind flowing by itself. The mind flows by itself is also one kind. That we don't call it as affinity. We call it as attachment. We call it as attachment. Why we call it as attachment is because it produces all the cycle comes. Krodha, lobha, madha, matsarya, bhaya comes. The six diseases, the six symptoms comes. Then what is practice here? Develop an affinity through understanding. First, the moment you develop an affinity to the valuable thing, you have to develop a, for the mind to practice, we said in the beginning, practice is difficult because mind is resisting it. For the mind not to resist and cooperate, some affinity is required. Only when you develop an affinity, mind will cooperate. When you are reading a novel, you love it so much, the mind is fully in cooperation. It's not that you have attained Nididhyasana meditation. You can't call that. You are watching a movie, you are just so glued, engrossed. என்னது என்ன மேன் இந்தியன் மேன் என்ன மேன் அது ஃபேமிலி மேன் ஃபேமிலி மேன் சார் ஃபேமிலி மேன் தெரியுமா ஃபேமிலி மேன் ஐ டெல் யூ மை காட் நெவர் சீன் எனிதிங் சோ போரிங் இன் மை லைஃப் ஃபார் 10 மினிட்ஸ் ஐ குடன்ட் இட் வாஸ் ஒன்லி ஸ்மோக்கிங் ஆஃப்டர் தட் இஸ் நாட் டுயிங் எனிதிங் அண்ட் எவரிபடி இஸ் கிளாப்பிங் ஃபார் தட் is only smoking and smoking avlo vera onnu nadakkala any problem pick up a cigarette avlo than problem is sorted out where is the difficulty you are so glued to that what will happen after a while what will happen after a while suddenly you will get the thought maybe if I pick up a cigarette I can sort out my issues are you able to follow the mind develops an affinity and you can't move out of it. Yeah. Season 2 is going on now. Season 2, I don't know how many episodes. For the mind to follow, you need an affinity. Now, the affinity can be developed in two ways. One is the mind by itself, by constantly running behind something, can pick up something. That is not affinity. That is simply attachment. Here, what are we talking about affinity? By knowing and understanding the value, the importance of something meaningful, what do you do? Even if the mind slips away, you force the mind. You say, do this, it is important. That is practice. That's called abhyasa. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagena cha bhukhyate. Are you able to follow? This is what is called as vairagya. And both goes hand in hand. Little bit of effort, little bit of vairagya, little bit of effort, little bit of vairagya. And when you pitch up an ideal like that and develop an affinity, vairagyam comes and helps. How does vairagyam comes and helps? Remember verse number 40 from chapter 2 onwards. Because the moment you fix an ideal and develop an affinity towards it, immediately the mind will ask. The same habit, it will continue. What is the question it will ask? Are you sure it will work? Huh? Are you sure it will work? Yes. How long it will take? Are you sure it will work? Teriyadu. Don't know. How long it will take? Shankar. Teriyadu. But practice. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha bhukhyate. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha bhukhyate. There is a total chaotic. It's like a whole lot of a congestion inside. It's like constant traffic jam inside. Nothing is. Everybody is honking and what they call as gridlock. Yeah, it's like that. Everybody is honking. Everybody wants to book, but nobody can. Abhyas. Practice, Arjuna. Practice. What should you practice? Little bit force. And mind resist any kind of force. Because mind sees force as inimical to it. Mind always misreads discipline as. Mind always misreads discipline as stifling. Are you able to follow? Discipline is something. Discipline is a kind of stifling only. Mind says no, no. Why it doesn't want any kind of discipline? Because discipline is always seen by the mind as stifling. I don't like to be controlled. I want to be
free.
Want to be free. Grandmother used to be, yeah, I want to be free na avuthu uta kalda maari irukka mudiyadhu, she will say. Yeah. It can't be. What is freedom? Is that freedom? What is freedom? The mind wants to be free and it doesn't understand what can give freedom and what gives freedom. Discipline gives freedom, and the discipline comes through effort. You just can't say I'm studying and not doing anything at all about it. Nothing will change. Are you able to follow? So two practices, abhyas and vairagya. Vairagya is knowledge. Abhyasam is whatsoever you have gained, you try to, nowadays what they call us, you try to apply it, you try to put it into practice. It was very difficult to wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning when I joined the course, because I had a habit of going to sleep very, very late. I used to do the stargazing, star watching, all Rajesh Nallam po. We'll go there and used to, you know, be dreaming the moon. Let's simply lie on the beach and dream. And behind this foreshore estate, it's a pitch dark place, beautiful place. Behind that foreshore estate. Slums, you can do that. I don't know how it is now. So we used to go there. So by the time we come back, it will be 1:32 to sleep. So it was very difficult to wake up at 4 o'clock. So I went and told Swami, I'm finding it difficult to wake up at 4 o'clock. He said, it's okay. What do you do? Yeah. He said, it's okay. What do you do? I said, I keep the alarm. 3:55, I wake up. Religiously wake up, put it off, and go back to sleep. Oh, you are keeping the alarm. I said, yes, that I do. 3:55, wake up and I put it off. It's okay. From next day, he said, keep the alarm in the cupboard, where you have to wake up, walk 3 steps to put it off. Even after that, you feel like sleeping, sleep. Abhyas, practice. And that 3 steps is like, the most excruciating things in the life is that three steps. Are you able to follow? Practice. Abhyas, practice. In order to practice anything, the mind must have an affinity. The mind must be relaxed. The mind must have an affinity to it, and the mind has to be relaxed. Then only you can practice. And how does the mind get relaxed? What is the technique of relaxing the mind? Adhithan sir, we do meditation. What is the technique of relaxing the mind?
Think of the blissful moments.
What is the way to relax the mind? Again, knowledge. The knowledge of karma yoga. Karmanyevadikaraste mapaleshu kadachana. You can only, your right is in the action, not on the results. Your right is in the action, not on the result. Neha vikramanashosti pratyavayona vidyate. Verse number 40, chapter 2. नेहा विक्रमणाशोस्ति प्रत्यवायो न विद्यते स्वल्पमप्यस्य धर्मस्य लिटिल बिट प्रैक्टिस इज व्हाट इज नीडेड अर्जुन लिटिल बिट स्वल्प स्वल्प मीन लिटिल बिट स्वल्पमप्यस्य धर्मस्य त्रायते महतो भया लिटिल बिट ऑफ दिस प्रैक्टिस यू विल बी प्रोटेक्टेड फ्रॉम ग्रेट फियर्स व्हाट आर यू वरिंग अबाउट बट माइंड अगेन विल कम विथ What if the effort goes waste? Wasted effort. Kramanasham. There is no such thing called Kramanasham. There is no such thing like that. There is no such thing called Kramanasham. Neha vikramanashosti pratyavayo na vidyate svalpamapyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhaya कर्मण्येवाधिकारस्ते मा फलेषु कदाचन मा कर्मफल हेतुर्भूहु मा ते संगोस्व कर्मणि यू कंबाइन 40 एंड 47 यू गेट रिलैक्स्ड यू कंबाइन दीज टू यू आर रिलैक्स्ड फॉर यू नो दैट देयर इज नो एफर्ट नेवर गोस यस द स्पीड विथ विच यू वांट द रिजल्ट इट मे नॉट शो Why? Because of your own past. The speed with which you want things to happen, you may not see it. Why? Because of your own past. So you understand this. You know what? Okay. Yeah. I have 100 crore debts, and I have repaid 1 lakh. What is the connection? But still something is repaid. Elsewhere, Ramatirtha gives a beautiful example about the low man and the high man. He gives a beautiful poetry. He says, there is the low man, there is the high man. There is the low man, there is the high man. The high man aiming for the millions misses the unit. The low man focusing on the unit, his hundreds soon hit millions. Able to follow? The high man and the low man. Ramatirtha gives a beautiful thing. The high man aiming for the million misses the unit. He's the high man. He thinks he's very high. Why? Because he's looking at the millions. The high man looking at the millions misses the unit. Misses the unit, now what does it mean? He'll be simply daydreaming about it. Nothing he will achieve. That low man, he looks like very low. Actually, whose eye? It's a pun. The low man is the high man, and the high man is that low man. Aiming at a unit, his hundreds soon hit billions. This relaxes the mind. Are you able to follow? So, this is how अभ्यासेन तु कौन्तेय वैराग्येन च दुह्यते बाय द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ वैराग्य एंड डिस्पैशन यू गेट आई एम नॉट गेटिंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिस्पैशन बिकॉज वी डिड इट लास्ट वीक आई रिमेंबर वैरी एनिमी राग द्वेष वी सॉ ऑल दैट डिस्पैशन इज नथिंग बट taking control. You understand it like that, you'll be very happy wanting to become dispassionate. Dispassion is nothing but taking control. You have lost the control. What is dispassion? You are making an effort to take the control back. You have lost the control. And mind is happy losing the control because of whatever we discussed about the mind. What is dispassion, vairagya? Vairagya is nothing but getting the control back. If you understand it like that, you will be motivated to practice. You will be motivated to practice. to develop an affinity to the higher through association. Satsangatve, nissangatve. Practice the third example. Third thing. Develop one. By good, keeping company of the good. Family man company keep on, na, what will happen? Rajaram, ungal theriyuma family man? He is saying, I am the family man. Theriyadilla? I know. Avaru theriyadhu, poor man. Avaru theriyadhu. That is the latest hit up. Season 1 episode, season 1, season 2. Edhula varudhu?
Prime.
It comes in prime. Full association. I knew that because I just ran through that yesterday. You know, the recommendation, watch. And if people are saying recommendation, something disastrous has to be there. I know that it can become so famous. You know that? If anything is becoming a hit, it means something disastrous is in that. I want to see what is the disaster in that. But the people are talking about it so great. What is the disaster? Yeah. All problems, solution is very simple. When you have a problem, drink. When you are joyful, huh? S.R. Shankar, when you are joyful, drink. When you are in sorrow, drink. Correct. Next thing, joyful, something good happens. Again? When you are stressed, smoke. And when you have solved the situation, relief. Again, what? Continuously associating with that, what you will think subconsciously, unconsciously, what will you think? Don't we have the freedom to do what we want to do? What is your problem? There is no problem. Vedanta is only saying the consequences of it. It doesn't have a problem. It's saying these are the consequences of it. And when you are suffering because of the consequences, don't blame anything. Don't blame anything external. These are the consequences. What are the consequences? Whatever be it. We know the consequences. What are the consequences of living through the mind? Ramatirtha says, stand in front of the mirror. You know the, when you stand in front of the mirror, you see yourself, you know what is the sequence. The third thing is what? Satsang, practice. Practice, satsang. In Bhajagovindam, very beautifully he says, satsangatve, nissangatvam, nissangatve, nirmohatvam, nirmohatve, nischalatatvam, nischalatatve, jivan muktihi. For Jivan Mukti, what is the starting point for Jivan Mukti? Jivan Mukti means liberation now. Liberated when you are alive. So what is the methodology? Another method. Satsang. Develop affinity by understanding the principle of Karma Yoga. The mind is relaxed. The third thing, you develop satsang. By develop satsang means good company, good association. Good association not in the sense of ethical and moral. We are not meaning it in that sense. It implies that also. But what good means is that which doesn't drag you down, that which doesn't pull you, that which doesn't pull you down. The mind itself has a natural affinity to go low. And I feed the mind with data and feed the mind with something that aggravates the flow. The Nippati U-turn Boda Vekarthu You have to stop it and make it take a U-turn. That is difficult. That is difficult in the sense mind would not cooperate. Mind would not cooperate. This is verse number 35. The answer. This is verse number 35. Beautiful is the verse. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. You get it by the two practices. The two practices of abhyasa. And the last practice of abhyasa is surrender. Where there is surrender, the mind relaxes. Another technique for practice is practicing surrender. Are you able to follow? How surrender helps? When you have surrendered, there is a relaxation. You will be able to follow. You go to the doctor, you have surrendered to the doctor, you are so happy, relaxed, following his prescription. Are you able to follow? So another practice is surrender. Surrender, satsang, whatever we give. Surrender, satsang, these are all the practices that comes under the discipline called abhyasa. And what is vairagya? Vairagya comes through knowledge, and vairagya comes through knowledge and understanding. And practice aids the understanding. Understanding makes the practice efficient. That's why both are interconnected. Practices aids the understanding. The understanding makes the practice efficient, better. Are you able to follow? Therefore, two things. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. We'll be quoting this verse any number of times. Just because these few verses we keep talking about it again and again and again. And very important verse. Verse number 35. Before we move on to 36, yes.
The mind is a slave to the world or something. It is a slave to the world and it complains. Na, the render is a connection.
Say that again.
Mind is a slave to the world.
Mind is a slave.
And it constantly complains.
See, correct. Yeah. See, slavery means, what is slavery? What is slavery? You are chained in all directions where you don't feel that you don't have the freedom to do what you, that is slavery. No. What is slavery? You are chained. You are bound. The mind goes and get attaches to everything that it encounters in life and complains of
what it got attached to.
Slavery. The mind gets attached and then, not realizing that it is the attachment that is causing the slavery, it complains that I have no freedom. Vedanta Krishna comes and says, you had freedom, but you lost it because of you getting attached. It's not that you are attached. It's not that you didn't have freedom. You had freedom. You went and got yourself attached. After attachment, you will not have any freedom, because after attachment,
not let go.
Attachment is leaving the control to the other. Yeah. What is attachment? I have left the control to the other. Parents attached to the children have left the control to the children. I tell you, the children say parents are suffocating. Huh? Actually, who is tortured more?
Parents.
The parents. Because at least the children can say, get lost and walk out. The parents can't even say, get lost. Correct, huh? Isn't it? Correct, no? Suffocating. attachment. Are you able to follow? Attachment. They get, you get attached, and then you give the control to that one to which you are attached, and then complain. What is the complaint? I don't have freedom. What is the solution now? One way of solution is pleading to the other. One solution is what? I beg to the other. What is begging to the other? Treat me properly. Don't agitate me all the time. Agitate me at least only once in a day, you agitate. Rest of the time, give me freedom. Bargaining. Bargaining going on. And for that, I will do something in. In return. Makes the suffocation more. Are you able to follow? Makes the suffocation more. What is the other way? Vedanta, beautiful is this word. Vairagya. Get detached. Get detached. And detachment is nothing but taking the control. Taking the control back. That's all. It is not hating the other or turning indifferent to the other. Only a person of strength can love. Even if you want to love and serve the other, you have to have strength. Only a person of strength can love the other. A weak person cannot love. And today, all the weak people think that they are in. They are loving, they are serving. First condition, and the only condition to serve is, you got to be strong. What is the strength? The mental strength. That is why this word vairagya, this word dispassion, detachment, is such a wonderful word, and you cannot miss this word in Vedanta. You cannot miss this word at all. And yet, we come into Vedanta and we miss this only. We come into Vedanta and we miss this. Is it okay? Detachment. Detachment is that which makes you strong. And when a man of strength, a person of strength alone can love, can serve. Like they say in the aircraft, put your masks first. If the air pressure drops down, the mask will come. Before helping the other, help yourself. Put the mask first. But the child is sitting next to me. Doesn't matter. If you want to help the child, you have to be. You got to be alive to help the child. No, when you yourself is suffocated, yeah, mask mukla podna, you'll put the mask in the ears. What will happen? Able to follow? That's why this vairagya is such a wonderful part. Verse number 36 padunga.
असंह्यतात्मना योगः दुष्प्रापहिति मे मतिः वश्यात्मना तुह्यतता शक्यो वाप्तुमुपायतः असंह्यतात्मना योगः दुष्प्रापहिति मे मतिः वश्यात्मना तुह्यतता शक्यो वाप्तुमुपायतः.
Yoga, I think, is hard to attain by one who is uncontrolled, but it can be attained by one who is controlled by means of striving. Yoga, I think, is hard to attain by one who is uncontrolled. But contrastingly, it can be attained by one who is controlled by means of striving. The continuity of the previous Again, it's continuing the same. It's continuing the same message. Again, he's agreeing with him. Correct, Arjuna? Vyasa enathu kaunteya vairagyenathu gukhyate enna. Arjuna would have gotten more angry now. Would have gotten more angry. So again, he's saying. Again, he's agreeing with him. Yoga, I think, is hard to attain. Asamyatatmana. By one who is uncontrolled. Uncontrolled means, what is uncontrolled? The impulses direct and dictate. That's what uncontrolled means. Uncontrolled means what? The impulses direct and dictate. Impulses means act first, which is appuram paathukalam. That is impulse. First do, then consequences na we'll see later. Consequence kosam ukkandunda nothing will happen. Therefore, just do. That is impulse. What is control? Control means the impulses are not allowed to decide. The course of action is not decided by the impulse. The course of action is not decided by the impulse. And again he says, it is difficult to control. I understand that it is difficult to control, Arjuna. Control implies telling the mind that you are wrong. And the mind will want to contradict avalada. Control means what? You are telling the mind what you are doing is wrong. Any number of times you say, the other person will not listen. The mind will not listen because you are telling the mind that you are wrong. And the mind will tell you what? And the mind will come up with its own thing to say that I am not wrong. That's all the fight is. What is the fight? The intellect is telling the mind that you are wrong. You are harming yourself. You are wrong in the sense of
self-destruction.
Mind turns back and say, I know. Correct. The mind turns back and say, the impulse is so powerful, it says, I know. Again, he is saying that. Asamshayatmana yogaha dushprapaha. Dushprapaha means impossible for the one who doesn't want to practice control. Dushprapaha means impossible. Impossible to whom? You can't lead an impulsive life and want to be. You can't lead an impulsive life. You can't lead an indisciplined life and expect growth. If growth is valuable to you, practice discipline. That's what in the previous verse we saw. If growth is important to you, if growth is valuable to you, if you think it is necessary, you got to practice discipline. दुष्प्रापः, दुष्प्रापः means it is impossible to, is impossible to accomplish. To whom? To the mind that doesn't want to practice discipline. No doubt it is difficult, Arjuna, but for whom it is difficult? Dushprapa, for the one who doesn't want to. But Vashyatmana tu yatata, tu means but to the one who has got control, it can be attained by one who is self-controlled, striving by proper means. Again, same verse repeating in a different way. Same idea, it's not a different idea, same idea. Are you able to follow? He's saying the self-control, striving obviously by proper means. By proper mean means, by following the krama, by following the sequence, by following the guidance of the shastras, what can obtain it? So who cannot obtain it? From this it is very clear, who cannot obtain it? Either the person is not striving, or striving by improper methods. Two possibilities. A person is not attaining it because there are two things that a person has to look into. What are the two things? One is self-control. Second is when I'm striving, the striving has to be proper means. I want to practice control, and then you can't do whatever you feel like doing. I hear something in the class today. Yeah. And then when you are stressed, open the YouTube video, somebody telling you, somebody guiding you there what you should do. And then after 2 minutes that gets bored, go to the next. At the end of the day, the practices are aggravating the problem. Why? Because two things is this: the self-control, striving by proper means can obtain it. Rephrase it, you can understand. It can be attained by one who is controlled by means of striving. What is striving means? The effort to reduce the desires. The effort to reduce the desires. Desires is the hope of the agitated mind. Desire is nothing but a hope of the mind that it will, if I get it, I'll be happy. What is a desire? Wanting, sir. Yeah. What is a desire? Desire is nothing but a hope. The hope of the unfulfilled mind to find fulfillment. That is what is known as a desire. So how much ever you achieve, how much ever you acquire, how much ever you get, what remains? The unfulfillment remains. The unfulfillment doesn't go. Desire continues. So from this you understand the psychology of desire. What is the desire? It's a hope. Desire is nothing but a hope. Hope of happiness. Desire is nothing but a hope. And Upanishad says, very beautifully the Upanishad says, of vain hopes. What is the desire? If you understand it from this angle, you know what is the role that desire is. What is the desire? Wanting. What is wanting? For not having it is painful. Having it, you think is going to give you? Not having it is painful. Having it will give you happiness, fulfillment, contentment. Correct? That way I called it as a hope. Not having it is painful. And the hope is what? If I get it, I'll be happy. I'll be fulfilled. So what is the desire? Desire is nothing but a hope of the unfulfilled mind seeking fulfillment. And that's why it is equated to fire. Because how much ever you feed, logs and logs and logs of wood can be fed to the fire, and the fire consumes everything and ready for more. Meaning, you go on acquiring objects. Carefully follow. Acquisition happens, unfulfillment remains the same. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. Janma after janma, you keep doing the acquisition happens. It's not that you don't acquire. Acquisition happens. But what you thought will happen through the acquisition doesn't happen. Acquisition, you get what you want. It's not that you don't get. Out of 10 things you wanted, you get 8 things in life. It means you should be, we all should be walking like a Nididhyasana students now. Yeah, because of the 10 things, that we want, we get 8 things. That one thing not there is enough, no? That one thing not there is enough to destroy everything. What is self-control now? That's what he says. For this kind of a person who's living life like this, yoga, I think, is me matihi. In my opinion, I think Krishna is saying, I think in my opinion, Arjuna, yoga is difficult for this person. But meaning for another one means who is self-controlled, striving through proper means, it can be attained. Same continuity. And then Arjuna comes up with a different, beautiful, again he comes up with a beautiful question. Arjuna Uvacha, verse number 37, padhi.
Arjuna Uvacha, ayate shraddhayopetaha. योगाचलितमानसः अप्राप्य योगसंसिद्धिं काम गतिं कृष्ण गच्छति अर्जुन उवाच अयते उपेतः योगाचलितमानसः प्राप्य योग संसिद्धिं काम गतिं कृष्ण गच्छति
अर्जुन सेड द अनकंट्रोल्ड हु पोसेसेस श्रद्धा फेथ हुज माइंड वांडर्स अवे फ्रॉम योगा फेलिंग टू अटेन परफेक्शन इन योगा व्हाट एंड ओ कृष्ण डस ही मीट. Three verses Arjuna is going to ask questions, 37 to 39. And in verse number 40, he gives from 40 to 45 is the answer. From 40 to 45 is the answer. Beautiful answer. Technically, it is called yoga brashta. Yoga brashta means one who has fallen. What happens to that? What happens? The fellow. All that he is saying is, verse number, chapter 6, verse number 36, varaikum ketutu, if I die, what will happen? திருப்பி சாப்டர் ஒன்ல இருந்து ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணணுமா? Or shall I be continuing with the next, or do I have to start from? Though possessed of faith, one who is endowed with faith, but effort is insufficient and the mind has strayed away. Krishna, காம்கதிம் கச்சதி, அவனுக்கு என்ன ஆகும், அவன் எங்க போவான்? If one is endowed with faith, but effort is insufficient. Look at the question. So practical this. Faith is there, effort is insufficient, and mind has strayed away from yoga. Mind wanders away from yoga. Failing to attain perfection in yoga, what happens to such a person? What happens to such a person? The uncertainty of reaching the cherished goal and the futility of a lifetime effort in not getting it disturbs the seeker's mind. Nothing but result orientation. Nothing great about it. Just the result orientation. That's it. It is. What is it? There is the cherished goal. Yeah. As a K to brainwash, like a kind of a brainwash. No, the classes K, like hypnotism. After a while, it becomes like a hypnotic condition it is. So a kind of Shraddha has developed now. A kind of Shraddha has developed now. That's what he's saying. Arjuna is saying that. That's the words. And I tell you this. That's why this Vedantic literature is so beautiful. Because how can a person be so either, how much they are able to take the question so practically and continue the conversation? So beautiful. Kam gatim. What end he will reach? What end he will reach? Gati means end. Yeah, gati means end. Hard work allam panni development agala. That's what he's saying. I'm all that you are saying, I'm doing. Ashaji, correct? No. All the hard work I'm doing, everything I'm doing, but change is not, growth is not happening, change is not happening. What will happen? What will happen? Typical example of the mind craving for the result and utilitarian attitude. Typical example. Craving attitude for the craving for the results and attaching utility to actions. Attaching utility to action means before the mind does anything, first question it will ask is, what will I get? Attitude of attaching utility to action. Second is craving for the results of action. This attitude of a seeker retards the growth. And we are going to see another beautiful answer. Previously, Arjuna asked, Chanchalam hi mana krishna balam dridam, all that he said. For which he gave an answer. What is the answer? Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. இதெல்லாம் பிராக்டிஸ் பண்ணி நிற்கும்போது பாதியிலே நின்று போச்சுன்னா வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன். இங்க வேற நெக்ஸ்ட் வீக் வில் கண்டினியூ எண்ட் த கிளாஸ் லைக் தட். நெக்ஸ்ட் வீக் வரைக்கும் நான் இல்லைன்னா, இஃப் ஐ எம் நாட் தேர் நெக்ஸ்ட் வீக், வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன் அகெயின், ஐ ஹாவ் டு ஸ்டார்ட் ஃப்ரம் திருதராஷ்டிர உவாச்ச தர்மக்ஷேத்ரே குருக்ஷேத்ரேன்னு ஆரம்பிக்கணுமா? ஆர் வாட் ஹேப்பன், ஹீ இஸ் சோ வரிட். ஒன் இஸ் த மைண்ட் நாட் கோஆபரேட்டிங் ஃபார் எஃபர்ட் இல்லையா. கொஞ்சம் எஃபர்ட் போட்ட உடனே வாட் கம்ஸ், லிட்டில் பிட் ஆஃப் எஃபர்ட்னா என்ன, ஓபன் டு த ஐஸ், அவ்வளவுதான். நத்திங் பிக் ஹஸ் ஹேப்பன், ஜஸ்ட் ஓபன் டு த ஐஸ், இமீடியட்லி வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன்? கிருஷ்ணா ட்ரஸ்டிங் யூ, ஐ லெஃப்ட் த வேர்ல்ட் அண்ட் ஆல் அண்ட் கேம் இல்லையா. ஸோ அங்கேயும் போச்சு, that is also gone, there is nothing here also. What is it that you are able to follow what he is asking? That's the question. That's a wonderful question. So that he is so what do you say, he is so dedicated, he is so much wanting to do, but the past comes in, the past habits comes and interferes. What a compassion. He has to start the answer all over again. What a compassion he has. From 40 la than he gives the answer. From 40 he gives the answer. 40 to 45 is the answer. So what is the question? I am convinced that I should put effort. Yes. I am convinced. Adar shraddha. We'll continue because the next three verses is only the same topic. So we'll continue it in the next class also. So the first thing that he is saying is, I have shraddha. What is shraddha? Trusting you, I left that. Shraddha, what I come to you, Krishna, but you are not giving any assurance, no? What is assurance that Krishna is not giving? Achirena adigachyati. He keeps on saying that. Very soon it will happen. Adi, very soon, yappo adha. 2021, 2022, 2035, when it is? The first question. Second question is, one is when he is not making the effort. At least I could have been in the world and enjoyed that. Enjoyed something, okay. Even there, there are some agitation, fight and friction. At least family and partner would have been happy. Yeah. Now that is gone now. Yeah. I can't look at the, see, I don't have any affinity for Netflix. Whatever you want to see, Netflix, you see, Prime Video, you see, I have nothing. So that is gone. And nothing is happening. That is gone. nothing is happening here. Kam gatim krishna gacchati, what end does he meet? Kam gatim, what happens to, what happens to such a person? What happens to such a person? Will not a lifetime be wasted in this pursuit? The uncertainty of reaching the goal is there. The uncertainty is there. At least in the worldly goals, you can fix up. Timeline, yeah. எல்லாத்துக்கும் டைம் லைன் வைக்கணுமே. வேர்ல்டி கோல்ஸ் தான் இப்போ இங்கே வந்து டைம் லைன் கேட்டால் கிருஷ்ணா சேஸ் வெரி சூன் இட் ஹேப்பன், வெரி சூன் இட் ஹேப்பன், ஹவு வெரி சூன் இட் ஹேப்பன், வெரி சூன் இட் ஹேப்பன். ஆன் தி ஒன் ஹேண்ட் யூ ஆர் பிரெயின் வாஷிங் சோ வெல், ஆன் தி அதர் ஹேண்ட் யூ ஆர் நாட் கிவிங் எனி அஷூரன்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. தட் இஸ் த ப்ராப்ளம். On the one hand, your brainwashing is beautiful, Krishna. I'm also getting so tempted to follow. I'm also getting so tempted to follow what you do. Okay, vanda edad assurance na, you are not willing to give any. And you are not willing to give any guarantee either. Kam gatim Krishna gacchati. What happens to that? What happens to that? And then he gives examples. In the next two verses, he gives examples. Will he not become like a rented cloud? Yeah, will he not perish like a rented cloud? He just goes all over the place and simply disappears. You look at the cloud, it gets so dark, and you think that it's going to pour. And then in 2 minutes, it's just, that's called rent cloud. Yeah, just simply gets dissipated, sunshine comes back. You start sweating again. Will that not happen to me? And finally, again, that's the beauty of Arjuna. How much ever he asks these questions, he surrenders. Krishna, who else is there to dispel this doubt other than you? Because you are the one who's brainwashing me. So I have to come to you are the one who's telling me all this. So he says, in verse number 39, again he surrenders. He explains all this in verse number 39. He surrenders again and he says, only you can dispel this doubt. For who else I can go to? Actually, also he can't go to anybody. No. Actually, who else I can go to? And he gives a beautiful answer. Next week we will read the questions again and then we move on to the answers. Venkat, is there anything? Nothing, no?
No, nothing. Bharat had a clarification, but he left.
Wow, nalladu. So, yosikarthukula, we'll conclude. We continue with the questions from the next week, because we need to see what is the uncontrolled possessing Shraddha. We need to discuss that.
Mohan has a question now.
அடுத்த வாரத்துல இருந்து கரெக்டா 9:00 நீங்களே லாக் அவுட்
பண்ணிடுவாங்க. I have noticed one thing. When we are saying six enemies, no? You always used to mention krodha, lobha, moha, madam, acharya,
bhaya. Bhaya, yes.
But kama also, generally people start with the kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madam, acharya.
Yes.
So why you are not mentioning about kama?
Because that desire is the cause. These six are the symptoms.
Okay.
So I am working backwards. I am saying by understanding the symptoms only we know the kama.
Okay.
Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsarya, bhaya is the. It's the traditional way of putting it. For practical purposes, I don't talk about kama and moha. Why I don't talk about kama and moha is because moha is the total destruction, delusion. Kama is the root of the problem. Now, when you go in any diagnosis, it is easy to start with the symptoms. That's a diagnostic method. By repeatedly knowing the symptoms. Even in the last 1.5 years, they are repeatedly bombarding the symptoms, no? Last 1.5 years, they are repeatedly bombarding the symptoms. Why? Because it is the symptoms that will quickly make you alert. So therefore, what I did for practical purposes, I kept it within brackets. It's implied. Kama and Moha is within brackets. I speak more about the symptoms. Are you able to follow, Mohan? Because it's easy to be alert. That's a scientific method. That's a proper scientific method. That's why they say if you have a cold, if you have a fever, if you have the symptoms. If you have a symptom, precautions can be better. The recovery, you can take precautions very fast, and you can make sure that the disease doesn't get stronger. That's why the symptoms are very important. So I keep on repeating this: krodha lobha moha madha matsarya bhaya, krodha lobha madha matsarya bhaya, only because these are the symptoms, and it is so 100% symptoms. So 100%, so complete it is that you can never miss it. In that sense, I keep repeating it. Lab technician madri vela paakuram avladhan.
Okay, thank you, Guruji.
Okay, Mohan.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, with this we conclude for today, and we continue with Arjuna's question 37.